Since Lucians are urged to encourage loved ones to remain in home quarantine. On July 9th, the country started welcoming returning nationals and visitors via airline flights after 3 months of border closures. Returnees must present a negative PCR test, undergo mandatory screening and quarantine to stay on island. Currently, over 424 individuals are home and institutionally quarantined, 70 at home and 254 in public health facilities. Returning nationals must spend some 14 days in mandatory quarantine before mingling with the rest of the population. However, some St. Lucians have attempted to skirt the law.
The Ministry of Health and Wellness asked that nationals and visitors adhere to the protocols for quarantine that have been put in place. The public is asked to cooperate and encourage family members and friends who have returned from overseas and are presently in home quarantine to remain there for the 14-day duration.
The police have been provided with a list of persons in home quarantine. The Health Ministry implores citizens to report any breach in protocols.
The public is advised that they should alert the nearest police station or the Ministry of Health and Wellness at 468-5349 or 468-5342 or 468-5312 with information in relation to anyone who breaches home quarantine guidelines. The Ministry of Health and Wellness once again appeals to everyone to support the national effort to minimize the threat of COVID-19 by adhering to these protocols.
Meanwhile, social activities have resumed.
Persons are encouraged to ensure the use of a face mask when in public, along with maintaining the 6 feet physical distance. Cover your mouth and nose with disposable tissue when coughing and sneezing, and also ensure regular hand washing with soap and water or an alcohol-based hand sanitizer where soap and water is not available. Although most sectors have reopened, the public is reminded that mass crowd events with over 200 people are still not permitted.
The 14-day mandatory quarantine also applies to guests who are confined to their COVID-19 certified hotel properties. However, last week, some visitors violated protocol, prompting a reinforcement of security at resort properties. As of July 16, 2020, there are 476 people in approved COVID-19 certified accommodations. Gina Filippi, HTS News Force.